Hey guys, Max from Incombo here, and today we are taking a look at the brand new OnePlus Nord CE 5G. This is OnePlus's brand new, just announced last week, kind of new mid-range entry into the ever-growing Nord series. The CE stands for Core Edition, so this isn't kind of a flashy new phone as such. It's kind of a tweaked version of the Nord we saw last year, which in itself was a very good phone, so I've got high hopes for this. We've got this box here, assuming this is kind of more of a press kit rather than the retail box, but we'll have a look in this box and see what you get in here. So it's pretty heavy, so I assume, yeah, there we go. So we've got a couple of cases for the phone. Here we go, so a quick look at these. We have, oh, it's got kind of a nice little pattern on it. We've got a blue case, we've got a black case, we've got a white case, and we've got a kind of lilac-y purple case. All of those look really nice. OnePlus cases always tend to be really good. So there you go. And then I assume this is the phone. Yep, here we go. So let's chuck that to the side. Here you go, this is the OnePlus Nord CE 5G. As I said earlier, this is the Core Edition Nord. So this is kind of just focusing on the stuff that OnePlus thinks is important. The Nord series, the OnePlus series is still fairly new for OnePlus, but it already seems to be super duper popular. They said during a briefing ahead of this phone that they'd sold over 1 million units, that it was the best selling OnePlus in Europe, and it was the best selling smartphone on Amazon UK in its launch month, kind of with the Nord from last year. So they're all pretty interesting figures. Obviously, OnePlus has kind of moved into selling pricier, more flagship devices, but it always used to be kind of more known for its cheaper devices, and that's kind of where the Nord sits. So let's just get into this box. We've got a couple of sticky tabs on the bottom here, so let's just open this up. So let's just open this up and see what's inside. See if we've got anything on the box. There you go. There we can see we have one with 12 gig of RAM and 256 gigabytes of storage in a blue void color. Nothing else there. Anything else on the back of the phone? Should see some more specs. Not really. We know it's got a Snapdragon processor. It's 5G. Nothing too interesting there. So here's the phone itself. Obviously in the blue void color that I mentioned before. So you can see, first off, this blue feels very OnePlus. We've seen OnePlus phones in this colorway before. I am not the biggest fan. There's also a grey version as well, which probably looks slightly nicer, but you know, it's still a fairly nice colour, stands out well, and especially this new matte back looks really nice, so I much prefer that to the shiny ones that OnePlus has used before. You can also see there's a camera module in the top with a 64 megapixel AI triple camera. Thank you very much for telling me that you've got that there. And on the front we have a 6.43 OLED 1080p display with a 90Hz refresh rate. Kind of, it does feel a little bit smaller. So I've got the iPhone 12 here for comparison. And as you can see, it's still bigger than the iPhone 12, but certainly smaller than some previous OnePlus device like the OnePlus 9 Pro, which was kind of a much larger device. Let's try and whack this on a little bit, see what we've got going on. So other features we've got going on, we've got a 4,500 milliamp hour battery, and there's Warp Charge 30T Plus, which should give you a full charge in pretty quickly. There's a, as I mentioned before, 90Hz OLED display, and there's two versions, so you can get it with 8 gigabytes of RAM and 128 gigabytes of storage, and then 12 gigabytes of RAM and 256 gigabytes of storage. No microSD expandability as there is on some of the cheaper Nord devices, but obviously, you know, when you can get 256 gigabytes of storage off the bat, it's not too bad. You've got glass on the front and glass on the back, and kind of a, is it plastic? It kind of feels like the Nord from last year. So the rim is plastic, but I don't think you'd really be able to tell it was plastic unless you've got someone like me telling you that it's plastic. It does still feel pretty good. While there is glass, OnePlus says that it's not Gorilla Glass. It's another variety of glass protection. And obviously the chip inside is a Snapdragon 750G 5G capable chipset. So while it is kind of more of a mid-range option, it still should be fairly capable. And especially kind of at the price this phone is coming in at. So the base model is £299, and the slightly juiced up version is £369. So again, definitely on the cheaper end of the scale. Let's just skip through all this and have a quick look at what we've got to work with. So accept, just a sec, agree. Let's ditch the screen lock. Skip, skip. I do like OnePlus's font, so let's set that. And I much prefer the navigation gestures, so let's set that as well. And then OnePlus do this really annoying thing where you have to kind of teach you how to do the things. So well done. And back, well done. And swipe up, well done. Thanks. And see your recent apps, well done. And set up complete. So in terms of software, this should look super duper familiar for anyone who's used a OnePlus phone before. This is running Android 11 with the Oxygen OS. I really like the Oxygen OS. You have kind of things like this. You have things like this shelf area, which can hold widgets and little shortcuts. And there's a little step counter there. I think there's a really, well, they used to have this really neat, parking location service. So you can kind of put in if you park your car and you can easily navigate back to it. So that's really nice. So that's, get that with a swipe down, and you should have the Google pane to the left, and then a swipe up takes you to all the apps. So I actually think this is nicer than the software you get on Pixels. OnePlus is also pretty decent at upgrading the software. So, you know, hopefully we'll get Android 12 on here and future updates and stuff. So that's nice to see. So yeah, you can see there we have Snapdragon 750G processor, 12 gig of RAM, 256 gigabytes of storage. There's a 64 megapixel main camera on the back, a 60 megapixel sensor on the front, 90 hertz fluid AMOLED display, blah, 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 all the stuff we kind of mentioned before. The screen, super really early impressions, but it does look really nice. OnePlus screens tend to be really good, especially these OLED ones. The colors on this wallpaper really do pop nicely, so that's always good to see. So yeah, kind of let's have a look around the phone. On the bottom we have, there you go, it's a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack and a USB-C port for the super fast warp charging. You've got a kind of camera one that sticks out a little bit, but not too much. Fairly flat screen on the front, which is what I always like. And on the side, you have your volume. So there isn't actually something I've just noticed. There isn't the kind of typical OnePlus alert slider here. I was kind of expecting to find it here, but it doesn't seem to be. And on this side, you just have your volume rocker. So no alert slider here, which is a little bit of a shame because I do really like that on OnePlus phones. Do you get a screen protector on the front? You do. Let's pull that off. It's just kind of one of those rubbishy plastic ones, so we can get rid of that. Yeah, the alert slider is a little bit annoying. I do like that a lot on OnePlus devices. So it's a shame it's taken off here. It is on the regular Nord, so that's something to kind of note if that's a particular OnePlus feature that you like. So there's the phone. Let's have a little look at, let's see what else you get in the box. Here we have a, oh, so if you don't want to kind of buy one of the cases that I showed separately, there are some, there is a little case included. I got this matte section on it and then some clear plastic. It feels all right. I'm not the biggest fan of these included plastic cases, but if you don't want to buy one, and it's probably gonna be fairly tricky to buy kind of third party case options for this, you've got one in the box straight away, so that's always good to see. What else we got in here? And here we just got a SIM tool and some Nord paper, safety information, whatnot. And then here, here's the warp charger. So you've got the typical OnePlus red cable. Now, unlike the OnePlus 9 and 9 Pro, which I believe have a USB-C to USB-C cable, this one has a USB-A to USB-C. And here's the pretty hefty plug. Not too hefty, actually, but there's the plug. And that will get you your warp charging. You'll only get the fastest warp charging if you use this, if you use that cable. So you'll probably want to keep that around. So yeah, this is the OnePlus Nord CE or Core Edition 5G version. It'll be available in the UK starting at £299 for the 8 gig, 128 gig model, and up to £369 for the 12 gig of RAM and 256 gigabyte version. Yeah, if you've got any questions on this Nord phone that you want answered, drop them in the comments below and I will get back to you. But that's all from me today. Thanks for watching and we'll catch you in the next video. Thank you very much.